Thank you. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, continuing the celebration of Easter, during which we give thanks to the Lord for the risen Lord, for the resurrection of His Son, let us also acknowledge that we were the cause of His suffering. He died on the cross because of us. And so, acknowledging that we are all sinners, let us ask God's pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who gladden us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joys. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter and John were going up to the temple area for the 3 o'clock hour of prayer. And a man crippled from birth was carried and placed at the gate of the temple called the Beautiful Gate every day to beg for alms from the people who entered the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms. But Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." He paid attention to them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "I have neither silver nor gold, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, rise and walk." Then Peter took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles grew strong. He leaped up, stood, and walked around, and went into the temple with them, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the one who used to sit begging at the Beautiful Gate of the temple, and they were filled with amazement and astonishment at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name, make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen one, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgment prevails.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Please stand.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus, And they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them, but their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, how our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have outstanded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us?' While he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us. So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, 'The Lord has truly risen and has appeared to Simon.' Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters, and I greet you once more with Happy Easter. How many of you can relate to the experience of Cleopas and his companion? How many of you can say, "Ganyan din yung naranasan ko eh"? What did they experience? Well, they were sad. They were disappointed. They were confused. We were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. They had hopes, high hopes. And yet, he is missing. You know, nung natalo po si Lenny nung 2022, marami sa mga kabataan ang umiyak. I was in Paco as a parish priest, and we had several volunteers for Lenny, young volunteers. And many of them, when Lenny lost, got disappointed. And many of them cried. That's why we even had to gather the youth volunteers in a kind of prayer session, therapy, ika nga, para makita ano ba ang gustong sabihin ng Diyos sa ating lahat sa mga ganitong pangyayari. That was the experience of the two disciples. Their hopes were crushed. Ganun din ba kayo, kumisan? Parang sunod-sunod yung problema dumarating sa buhay, and then yung mga tao na inaasahan mo ay binigo ka, naging taksil sa iyo, o nakalimutan yung kanilang mga pangako. But then, katulad din ba tayo ng mga alagad patungo sa Emmaus, nakasama pala nila si Jesus na naglalakad, kasama pala nila si Jesus sa kanilang mga diskusyon nang hindi nila napansin. I think that is the problem of many of us. We complain that God has not been with us. We complain that God has not been listening to our prayer. Di ba may kantang natutulog ba ang Diyos? How many times have we asked that question? Natutulog ba ang Diyos? May pakialam ba ang Diyos sa akin? Mahal pa ba ako ng Diyos? And all throughout, God has been with us. Yun ang naging problema ng mga alagad patungo sa Emmaus. Kasama nila si Jesus na naglalakbay, pero hindi nila napansin. My dear brothers and sisters, perhaps that is the grace that we should be praying for today. Lord, let me see you being present in the many happenings of my life. Lord, let me feel your presence, especially during sad times, so that I will not have any doubt that you are with me along the way. Yun ang hingin nating biyaya. Kasama natin ang Diyos, kasama natin si Jesus, sana makita natin ito. Amen.
Please stand.
Recalling how the disciples on the road to Emmaus recognized Jesus in the breaking of the bread, we pray to God the Father for a deeper appreciation of the risen Christ as our spiritual food for the journey through life. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Pope and the bishops may effectively proclaim the message of hope by their holy lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders may bring hope and light to our people by their dedication to public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may understand why Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may be healed and be strengthened by the reception of the Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may enjoy the fullness of life in the company of the risen Christ, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, grant us the deep faith necessary to recognize your Son in all situations we experience in life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice which has redeemed the human race, and be pleased to accomplish in us salvation of mind and body, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim, Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family, let us pray to our common Father in heaven, in the words given to us by his Son.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, it's Wednesday again, and tonight at 9 p.m., let us join the community of the Diocesan Shrine and Parish of St. Vincent Ferrer in Tabaco City, Albay, in the praying of the Rosary for the family, our Wednesday Family Rosary at 9 p.m. So you are all invited to join us by Facebook page of the Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of His only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness of His blessing.
Amen.
May He, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in the right manner on this earth, be united with Him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
Thank you.